this rookie series of tutorials is for new users of iMovie 10.2. It'll quickly get you started and help you understand how to easily create videos on your Mac. The videos use my years of editing experience to cover just the items you need to know without going into unnecessary details that will bog you down. But if you're looking for a quick start video, well, click the I above for a 2-minute tutorial that'll get you off and running in iMovie. I assume you already have iMovie on your Mac, but if not, you can download it free from the Apple App Store. If you want to follow on with my media, you can download it from my website, or you can use your own media. Or click the I above for a link to my website that has the media for you to download. When you first launch iMovie, you'll see this screen. If you've already tried iMovie before, you'll likely have other projects on your screen like this. If you don't see either of these screens, click the Projects button at the top in the middle of your iMovie window, or Projects at the left of the screen. As you create more projects, they'll appear in this window. Let's get started by creating a new project by clicking on Create New. You'll be given the choice of a movie or a trailer. You'll look at trailers in a future tutorial. Just click Movie now. If this is the first time you've used iMovie, you'll be presented with a blank screen with an untitled event under the iMovie library words. So change untitled to My First Movie. Otherwise, you'll see your previously created projects. In order that you all see the same thing, if you have previous projects, select the library name in the file menu, select New Event. An event will show with today's date. Change the date to My First Movie. Whatever method you've used, My First Movie should be showing now. Next, you'll need to import some media. That's the camera video files, or stills, or audio, music, etc. Files can be imported two ways, either by clicking the downward arrow or by dragging files from the Mac's Finder. If you downloaded my files, they'll be in the Downloads folder on your internal disk, or use your own videos if you prefer. In my opinion, this first method is the easiest. Go to the Finder button in your dock, drag the iMovie course material folder on top of My First Movie. Otherwise, click the Import Media and select the media in your Users folder. On your screen now, you'll see three types of files. There's Photos, that's got a camera icon that shows on the left. There's Video Clips, and there's Audio, which has got waveforms showing in it. You can see different views of these clips by clicking the gear wheel. Clip Size resizes the clip, Zoom shows more detail in the clips, and Waveform shows the audio portion of video clips. Drag Zoom a little to the right. You can hover the playhead over video clips, and that allows you to see the action in those clips, which shows in the viewer on the right. Click the first video clip. A yellow outline encloses it. Click the white plus sign. The whole clip will jump into the timeline, and you can play that clip by pressing the space bar. Not so much. It's press awkward. Again to pause, or hover the playhead over a clip as you did in the browser. This is a good time now to learn the different areas of the iMovie interface. You need to know where things are. The clips you imported are in the browser. The panel to the right is the viewer. It shows wherever the playhead is positioned, in the browser or in the timeline. Next, you'll select just a portion of the second video clip. Click on the clip and the yellow outline appears. If you look carefully, you can see handles on either side of the clip. This allows you to trim off the beginning and the end of the raw clip in the browser before you add it to your timeline. This is known as pre-editing. As you trim, you'll see the length of time you've selected. You can now press the plus sign or drag the clip into the timeline, and only the portion has been added. You can also select a group of clips and add them to the timeline by command-click or lassoing. And they can be added to the timeline by pressing the E key. If you look in your timeline now, you'll likely only see part of the edit. You may wonder where everything's gone. Well, before I finish this first lesson, I want to give you some advice from experience. You need to be able to view the timeline in different ways. And here's my secrets for you. To see all of the timeline in one view, this is known as fit in window, use the keyboard shortcut Shift plus Z. You could also use the slider on the right where it says settings. And a tip, the view that you see is centered on the position of the playhead. I suggest you practice at this. My opinion, seeing what you need in the timeline as either a detailed view or a wide-angle view is the one thing that frustrates new editors the most. I strongly suggest that you remember these next two keyboard shortcuts to really speed up the change in view and smooth your editing just like a professional editor. Command plus is to zoom in and Command minus is to zoom out. Zooming in will show you more detail, and zooming out will give you a wider view. In the next lesson, I'll show you how to trim the clips of the timeline, as well as add titles, transitions, and effects. I'm here to help, so if you need assistance on a specific iMovie topic, I offer free iMovie support via email, and that's for urgent issues that you're confronted with. Click the I above for a link to my free support site. Otherwise, let me know in the comments below about iMovie topics that you struggle with, and I'd be happy to produce a YouTube video to help you solve those issues. I'm also available for one-on-one internet training. Thanks for watching, and if you haven't done so already, please like, subscribe, and press the bell.